Hello students, I hope you all are doing well. So today I am here to take up the new chapter. Yes, the new chapter in your English literature book, chapter number 5, The Golden Boy. Yes, so before starting the chapter, I would like to give you a small gist of the story which we are going to read just now, The Golden Boy. Yes, so this is a story about a golden boy, as it is clearly mentioned here, the golden boy, of course. So this is a story about the golden boy. Who could sing beautifully. So this bird, she got a very beautiful voice. So that is why for her beautiful voice, she was kept in a kingdom. Yes, the king kept this bird in a kingdom because the king was very much impressed by this bird's voice. That is why she was kept in the kingdom in a golden cage. Yes, this bird is a golden bird and it was kept in a golden cage. So one fine day, the king thought that it is not good to keep the bird in a cage. The king was thinking that he should leave the bird free, set her free and leave her free so that she can lead her own life. She can lead her life free, the life full of freedom, because earlier it was kept, the bird was kept in a cage, right? So now the king was thinking that the bird should go and lead her own life with freedom, without restrictions, with freedom. So he left the bird. Okay, so he asked his people, the people in the kingdom, he asked them to leave the bird and set her free. So the bird went out. Now the bird went to the forest. This bird went to the forest, golden bird went to the forest, and when she went there, the bird has got a proudy nature. Means she was not in a habit to talk to people politely. So when she got new friends like monkey, chameleon and snake, they came to her and they spoke to her very politely. But then this bird, she got a very proudy nature, so she did not reply to them proudly, nicely. She thought that, oh, she is superior to everyone. So she replied in a very bad manner because she was thinking that I am gifted, I am talented, and the other animals in the forest are not talented and they don't have any talent and they are useless. This bird is only superior. This bird is only superior because she was being praised by everyone in the kingdom. So she was thinking she got this superiority complex. So she was not talking to them properly. But you know what happened? When one fine day, this bird got into trouble. Yes, this bird got into trouble. So who helped this bird? Those animals only helped this bird. Yes, the bird was showing attitude to those animals. But you see, in difficult times, who helped her? The animals. The animals of the forest, the chameleon, the snake, and the monkey helped her out when she was in trouble. So what we understood, that we should not show attitude to people. We should not be impolite to people. Rather, we should be kind and polite when we talk to people, and we should not develop superiority complex. We should not think that, oh, I am good, so I will not talk to these people. I am very good, I am very intelligent. So we should not think like that, because everyone should be respected equally, whether they are superior to you or whether they are inferior to you. You should not make them feel that they are less talented than you. So yes, this was the story, and we'll see how this happened and what all things took place. So that we'll see in the story. But this is a story about a golden bird who earlier was a very rude kind of a bird, but later on she developed this polite nature because of the troublesome situation happened in her life. She came to know that be kind to people is a good way to lead life. So now we'll see what happens in the story. I'm going to read paragraph wise and then I'm going to explain it all. So please follow where I'll be reading, what I'll be reading, and then because I'll be reading and explaining at the same time. So here I go. Please open page number 33. There was once a king who had a golden bird in golden cage. Every day someone in the palace gave her food and water and groomed her fine yellow feathers. And each day the bird sang for the king. But as time passed, the king began to feel sorry for the bird. It's not right, he thought, to hold a bird in a cage. So he told his men to set her free. The men took the cage deep into the forest, set it down, opened the door and went away. So in this paragraph we see, as I already told you, that there was once a king. There was once a king who had a golden bird. This king had a golden bird in a golden cage. So this king especially made a golden cage for his bird, the golden bird. And every day someone in the palace, every day what used to happen, every day someone in the palace, there were some people in the palace who used to give her food and water daily. Who? The bird, yes. And groomed her. Groomed her means, you see the meaning is given, the word in red color given in your book, groomed. So groomed means brushed and cleaned. Brushed and cleaned. Brushed and cleaned what? Brushed and cleaned the bird and its feathers or its wings. So they used to do that for her. Yellow feathers. The bird has got, this golden bird has got yellow feathers. So every day the people in the kingdom used to brush and clean her yellow feathers. Fine feathers. Fine means very soft, thin and small. So every day what they used to do? Every day they used to clean birds. Fine means very soft, thin and small feathers properly. So that was their work. Every day they used to give her water, food, and they used to brush and clean its feathers, yellow feathers, small feathers, soft feathers. So they used to clean them. But as time passed, the king began to feel sorry for the bird. It is not right, he thought, to hold a bird in a cage. So he told his men to set her free. So as time passed, the king began to feel so. After some time, the king began to think. So he used to think that it is right to keep this bird in a cage. I think it is wrong, because the king was feeling sorry. Feeling sorry for means, you see the meaning is given here. Feel sorry for means, feel sad about. So he was feeling sad. Sad for whom? Sad for the bird, because the bird was kept in a cage and it could not move freely. The bird could not move freely. The bird could not go out of the kingdom. So the king was feeling sad for the bird, and the king thought that I think I should set this bird free. Set her free means, you see the meaning is given. Set her free means let her out of the cage so that she could go wherever she wanted. So set her free means the king wanted to leave the bird free so that she can go wherever she wants. She should not have any restrictions. She could go freely wherever she wants. Because if we'll also be kept in a room, so we'll also feel bad, right? So similarly, the bird was also feeling bad because it was only kept in a cage. It could not go out. The bird could not go out. So the king was feeling sorry for the bird. So one fine day, what he did? He asked his men, the people who were working in the kingdom, he asked the men to take the bird, take this cage and leave the bird into the forest or anywhere, wherever you want it, so that this bird can go out and lead her life free. Yes. So the bird was kept out. Now the men went to the forest and they opened the cage and they set the bird free. So the bird went out. Now the golden bird was looking here and there. Yes. She was looking here and there and she looked around her, and now she is hungry. Yes, the bird was hungry. So because she doesn't know what to do, because now this place is new for her, because she was living in the kingdom for so many years and people were serving her, right? People were coming and giving food to her. She was not going anywhere and asking for food, right? So she was not habitual to this atmosphere, this environment. Now this forest environment is new for her, right? So now we'll see what happens in the next paragraph. Now the next paragraph. After a while, she saw a monkey swinging from a tree. "Hello there," said the monkey. "Who are you?" The bird tossed her head and said, "I am the golden bird." "I can see you are new to the forest," said the monkey. "Do you want to see the best places to feed?" So in this paragraph, we see that after a while, means after some time, now the bird went to the forest. So she saw a monkey. Now, you know, in forest, so many animals stay there, right? So the monkey was there. He was swinging from tree. So he was hanging on the tree. And he just saw the bird and he asked, "Hello there." He said, "Hi." When we meet somebody, some new people, we say hi or hello, right? So in the same way, monkey also said hello to the bird. But the bird replied very rudely, "Who are you?" Because she was very proud. She was rude. This bird was very rude. So she said, "Who are you?" The bird tossed her head. Tossed her head means, you see the meaning is given. Tossed her head means moved her head back proudly. She was very proud in nature, right? So she was moving her head like this. "Who are you?" Like this. Like she was very rude and she was very proud. She was asking, "Who are you?" Okay. And said, I'm the golden bird. She said, I'm the golden bird. She was very proud that she was a golden bird who can sing beautifully. So she was saying in a proud tone, who are you? I'm the golden bird. She said like that. I can see you are new to the forest, said the monkey. Do you want to see the best places to feed? So the monkey said, I can see you are new to the forest. Because now the monkey was known to the other animals, right? He knew other animals. But the monkey saw this new bird. So the monkey knew that this bird is new to the forest. So he said, Do you want to see the places to feed? To feed means to eat something, right? Because the bird was hungry and the monkey could sense that. So the monkey asked her, come on, I'll show you the places from where you can eat your food. You can get your food. But we don't know what the bird replied. So now we'll see what happens in the next paragraph. What can a monkey teach me? Replied the bird. And you have such a funny face. Have you seen my beautiful beak? She added. Do as you like, said the monkey, as he swung off into the trees. Sometimes later, the golden bird heard a hissing noise in the grass and saw a snake. So, in this paragraph, we see that earlier the bird replied very rudely to the monkey that who are you? But the monkey still replied politely that okay, no problem, I'll come and show you the place to feed, to eat. But what the bird said? Bird said, what can a monkey teach me? She was thinking that bird is very superior and monkey is nothing. So she was saying to the monkey, what can you teach me? You are such a monkey, you have a funny face, what you can do? Who are you to teach me? I am a golden bird. She was proud. Okay. So the monkey replied to the bird, the bird replied to the monkey, have you seen my beautiful beak? Means she was trying to show off. Yes, the bird was trying to show off to the monkey that have you seen my beautiful beak? The bird's beak, you know, na? The bird's beak. So she was telling to the monkey, have you seen my beautiful beak? And have you seen your funny face? She was comparing herself with monkey. She was thinking that she was better than that monkey. Monkey has got a funny face and she has got a beautiful beak. The bird was telling like that. What can urge do as you like, said the monkey as he swung off into the trees. Swung off into the trees means, you see the meaning is given. Swung off into the trees means move from one tree to another by swinging on the branches. So when the bird replied rudely and when she started showing off, the monkey said, do as you like, do whatever you want to. The monkey also got very angry, but he felt very bad because the bird was insulting him. So he said, okay, do whatever you feel like, I'm going. So he went off swinging on the tree, then he went off. Sometime later, the golden bird heard a hissing noise in the grass and saw a snake. Now, sometime later, after some time when the monkey left, the golden bird heard a hissing noise. And who makes this hissing noise? The snake. Yes, the snake came into the forest now. So now we'll see what happens in the next paragraph. Next page. But for today only this much is there. I'm going to take only the first page of the chapter. But once again, I'm going to explain the entire page in Hindi so that you can understand. It is just for your convenience. But I'm going to explain in short the first page. So ये जो story है वो एक golden bird की है. मैंने आपको बताया golden bird मतलब सुनहरी चिड़िया. सुनहरी चिड़िया की कहानी है जो कि बहुत ही सुरीला गाती है. उसकी आवाज बहुत ही मीठी है. वो बहुत अच्छा गाती है. लेकिन वो किससे कौन से ज्यादा प्रभावित है? किंग. किंग मतलब राजा. तो जो किंगडम का राजा थे वो उससे बहुत ही खुश थे, इसलिए वो उसको अपने किंगडम में ले आए थे. क्यों ले आए थे? क्योंकि वो जो गोल्डन बर्ड थी, जो सुनहरी चिड़िया जिसे कहते हैं, वो बहुत अच्छा गा सकती थी. अब वो बहुत टाइम से जो चिड़िया थी वो एक केज में थी. केज मतलब पता है आपको, पिंजड़े में रहती थी. वो बाहर नहीं जाती थी, कहीं नहीं जाती थी, जिसे देख के राजा को बहुत दया आती है. बहुत उसको बुरा लगता है इस चिड़िया पे. तो वो सोचता है, वो अपने आदमियों से बोलता है जो उस राज्य में काम करते हैं, उससे बोलता है कि जाओ इस चिड़िया को छोड़ाओ, क्योंकि बहुत टाइम से इस पिंजड़े में बंद है और मुझे देख के अच्छा नहीं लग रहा. तो वो लोग जाके उसको जंगल में छोड़ाते हैं, क्योंकि राजा ने आदेश दिया था. तो वो लोग जाके इसको महल से ले जाके उसको जंगल में छोड़ाते हैं. किसको छोड़ाते हैं? गोल्डन बर्ड को. अब वो जंगल में उसको जब छोड़ के आए, तो ये जो गोल्डन बर्ड थी, ये पता कैसे नेचर की थी? इसका जो नेचर था बहुत ही रूड था. रूड कैसे कह देंगे? वो बहुत ही अपने घमंडी टाइप की थी. जब आप कहते हैं ना, जो बहुत इंटेलिजेंट होता है, जिसको हर चीज का ज्ञान होता है, वो अपने आप में घमंड करने लगता है. तो ये चिड़िया भी बहुत ही घमंडी बन चुकी थी. इसको इस चीज का घमंड था कि ये बहुत सुंदर है देखने में और ये बहुत अच्छा गा सकती है, और इसको लगता था कि ये सबसे अच्छी है, सबसे अच्छी यही है और उससे अच्छा कोई हो ही नहीं सकता। तो इसको थोड़ा घमंड था। अब ये जंगल में पहली बार आई है, नई थी, इसको भूख लग रही है, लेकिन अभी किससे बोले, क्योंकि महल में तो इसको सब खुद खाना ला के देते थे, इसको कहीं जाना नहीं पड़ता था, तो इसको आदत नहीं है खाना लेने की या ढूंढने की। तो ये जंगल में किससे मिलती है, मंकी से, मंकी मतलब बंदर से मिलती है। अब बंदर से मिलती है तो बंदर इससे कहता है कि आप मुझे नहीं लग रही है इस जंगल में, चलिए मैं आपको जगह दिखा देता हूँ जहां से आप खाना ले सकते हैं। लेकिन ये बर्ड कैसी है, ये बहुत ही घमंडी है, हाँ इसको अपने पर बहुत घमंडी कहती है। तो वो कौन, उसको कहती है मंकी को, उसको लगता है ये बंदर तो कुछ नहीं है, इसका एक फनी सा चेहरा, मतलब जोकरो जैसा चेहरा है इसका, और ये मेरे लिए क्या करेगा, मैं तो बहुत अच्छी चिड़िया हूँ, गोल्डन बर्ड हूँ मेरी, देखो मेरी सुंदर सी बीक, आपको पता है चोंच देखो मैं कितना सुंदर गाती हूँ, तुम हो कौन, तुम्हारे पास तो कुछ नहीं है, वैसे कहती है। जिससे मंकी सुनता है तो उसको गुस्सा आता है, किसी को भी गुस्सा आ जाएगा जब आपसे मैं प्यार से बात करूंगी और आप मुझे गुस्से में जवाब दोगे घमंड के साथ, तो आपको भी गुस्सा आएगा ना कि मैं तो इससे प्यार से बात कर रहा हूँ, इसकी हेल्प कर रहा हूँ, और ये मुझे को एटीट्यूड दिखा रही है, मुझे को घमंड दिखा रही है। तो मंकी क्या करता है, चला जाता है उचकते उचकते पेड़ों पर चला जाता है, कहते ठीक है जाओ जो तुम्हें करना है करो, मैं तो जा रहा हूँ। अब जब वो मंकी चला जाता है तो वो सुनती है किसकी आवाज, सांप की आवाज, हिस वाली आवाज, हिस वाली आवाज सुनती है कि कौन आ रहा है, सांप आ रहा है। सो यस, दिस वॉज द स्टोरी, ये स्टोरी थी फर्स्ट पेज की। द नेक्स्ट पेज आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो, बट फॉर टुडे ओनली दिस मच इज देयर। आई विल एक्सप्लेन द एंटायर पेज बोथ इन इंग्लिश एंड इन हिंदी। सो यू नो व्हाट इज योर होमवर्क, यस यू हैव टू राइट द डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स व्हिच आई हैव अंडरलाइन इन द बुक। यू हैव टू राइट दीज डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स इन योर rough notebook, not fair notebook, but rough notebook. You have to write these difficult words which I have underlined in rough notebook and learn the word meanings which I have written on the board. You have to learn them. No need to write these word meanings in copy. You just have to learn these word meanings and write the difficult words which I'll be showing just now in your rough notebook. So yes, that's all for today. Thank you. So yes, these are the difficult words which I have underlined in the book and you have to write it down in your rough notebook. Yes, please copy these words carefully in your rough notebook and then learn them. Learn the difficult words and learn the word meanings. So this is your homework. You have to copy these difficult words carefully, okay? So yes, that's all for today. Thank you.